Soup. Checking out this to start up a new social website, because I've been haven't had much fame on Facebook, Twitter, MySpace, Xanga, LinkedIn, and all these top social media websites to find other people. So I just see the YouTube has been famous for a lot of people, so I wanted to do it myself. Show y'all a little bit about myself. Yes, I come from a long history of abuse, a lot of verbal, physical abuse, and sadly, I'm still here. I love it. They can't stop me. They can't kill my soul. They won't be able to hurt me. I live, eat, and sleep Jesus 24/7. He's always with me. As always carrying him with me at all times. He's my best friend. He's my guidance. He's tattooed. I got a cross on me right there with a little Floyd Clover. And I got John 5:24. And I have never give up with my initial CMH as a paraphrase and the cross on top. I have Matthew 1:1. And I have Luke on my body as well. I love the Bible. I love the New Testament. I love everything about it. Sadly, I don't love the hate and appreciation that I don't get. I will always love and forgive those, and they will come to me one day later down the road and say they're sorry. They keep telling me they're going to pray for me every day, but I keep telling them they can keep tell their prayers to the grave. If they really wanted to pray for me, they could come to my house or come call me face to face and see my struggles of what I've been through. I just got out of the mental hospital yesterday, and that was probably the worst thing I've ever gone through. Worst time visit that I've been in the mental hospital in MTMHI in Nashville, Tennessee, with everyone, with a woman pulling her hair out, banging her head against the wall, and the guards and them just telling her, just keep banging your head on the wall, it's your head, it's your head, it's not hurting us. I mean, I have to deal with people fighting left and right, people cursing down on my family when they didn't even know my family, and they were just saying my last name and some of my family's last name, and they were just saying, oh yeah, I murdered the Huffman, I murdered the Cochran, I murdered the Pendergrass, I murdered the Molinas, I murdered everybody. I'm like, how do y'all know these people? How do y'all know this? This is my family. And it hurts me deep inside, because I'm just like, God sends me to that place every single time. And I used to call it heaven, that I used to go there and meet all these spiritual people. But now it's more of a hell. I love you all deeply, and just check me out on Facebook, Corey Matthew Huffman. I got a Facebook that I created. It's called Mr. John 524 Online Basic Instructions Before Leaving Earth. And I have a lot of spiritual people from other countries and other states on there that share their insight on their God's love. And right now I'm at about 1,800 to 2,000 people strong on the group. And I used to post a video every day of me recording and reading the Bible every day, because that gives peace out of my body. And gives me love. It gives me just everything that I need. I don't believe in money and money and working for money every single day of life and worrying about stress and bills, because I know God will provide with me. If I just ask and I shall receive. If I work in a part-time job and have split bills with my dad and split them with my sister, and we take care of each other, we don't have to burn our bodies out every single day. And it's all about taking care of the family, taking care of my fiance, my girlfriend, taking care of her and making sure she has everything that she needs. And because that's all we need is just the love. And I don't need the hate of everyone saying that I post Jesus, saying I love Jesus all the time, and people tell me to stop posting that, or people, whenever I post videos of different rappers and things like that, and they say, oh, all he does is talk about weed and all that. No, if you actually watch the videos, and you watch the lyrics and the music and the sound that the artists are producing, they're not really just talking about drugs. They're talking about their spiritual life. They're 100% how they live their life. And y'all keep judging us and judging me and others, but y'all know what y'all are doing to yourself. Y'all are just hurting yourself and just trying to hurt me and trying to hurt other people. Call yourself a Christian and you're trying to get everyone to be a Christian. Let them leave peaceful. Let them live life. Let them appreciate it. We shouldn't have to force something down someone's throat. Let them, just give them a couple words and watch them come to you. Watch them come to you in the next coming years. They will see that they need God when they're down and out. 1968, they took all the Bibles out of the public schools and they put them into jails, prisons, and the hospital. Sadly, that's when everybody picks up their Bible and wants to repent and forgive and tell their sins all the way. And that's when they receive their Christ as their Savior in their life. Much love to everybody. Hope y'all got something out of this. And you can all just smile and thankful because I get to watch my movie, Rudy. My favorite movie of all time in the world. It's all about family. My favorite movie of all time, Rudy. So I'm going to be Rudy again one day. I did Rise to the Top in high school. And then I fell off and went to my addiction. But now I'm back on my life again. I beat my addiction. Want everybody to get their addiction with me again. Much love. Appreciate it. C-O-R-Y. Youth Rising. Offering Christ. Matthew. Jesus Christ. Ancestors of Jesus Christ. Huffman. Because I huff for the man. Thank y'all.